check the 3D bite plates created by the dental lab. Make sure that there is enough space to accommodate the lip and the cheek frena. When the patient closes his mouth, make sure that the bite plates close in a parallel and flat position. The patient should not feel any pain in the process. Thoroughly rinse the tray and dry it. Apply a suitable adhesive around its circumference. On the prepared margins, apply an appropriate precision impression silicone, for example, virtual heavy body, and carefully rotate the impression tray into the mouth. Ask the patient to suck on your finger once or twice, and then to move the lower jaw to the right and to the left. This activates the muscles. Next, insert the tray in the lower jaw. Ask the patient to close his mouth. While the patient lightly bites on the bite plates, he is asked to make certain functional movements. He alternates between pursing the lips and smiling. These movements should be repeated 8 to 10 times. Subsequently, the jaw should remain closed while the material sets completely. Trim the material pressed on the inner surface of the tray back to 2 millimeters. Excess in the dorsal area should also be removed. Coat the inner surface of the tray with an adhesive varnish and then load it with a low viscosity silicone, for example, virtual light body, for the basic or wash impression. Insert the tray and lightly press it into place. It is important to remove any excess that is pressed out on the dorsal aspect immediately. Ask the patient to suck on your finger again. This allows you to determine if impression material is still flowing towards the throat. If this is the case, remove it. The next steps are carried out in the same way as those for the impressioning of the functional margin. Small voids and inaccuracies can be corrected with virtual extra light body. For this purpose, proceed in the usual way. When the tray is removed, the suction effect should be perceptible. All the important anatomical details should be visible, without any voids. Excess material must be removed, in the area of the tuberosities in particular. The functional impression of the lower jaw takes place in the same way as that of the upper jaw. The only difference is that instead of having the patient suck on a finger, they are asked to stick out their tongue and move it to the left and to the right a few times, and then move it along the upper lip. Insert the upper impression and ask the patient to carry out the functional movements with the mouth closed. In addition, the patient should swallow once or twice. The process is always the same. In other words, for the shaping of the functional margin, the wash impression, and any necessary adjustments with virtual extra light body, for example, remove any excess in the area of the retromolar pads in particular. This will ensure smooth movements at a later stage. Check the stability and suction of the impression. When the jaws are closed, the bite plates should be positioned flat on top of each other. Now you can determine the final position of the occlusal plane. Align the basic bow of the UTS CAD parallel to the camper's plane and the bipupillary line using the bite fork. Record the measurements and send them to the dental technician for the denture design. Check the vertical dimension by testing the patient's speech and then make any necessary adjustments. Ask the patient to say words such as 66 or Mississippi, or have them count from 60 to 70. If the vertical dimension is too high, the bite rims will touch each other when the patient speaks. In this case, remove one of the rims and test the situation again. If the vertical dimension is too low, you can increase it in millimeters with wax plates. The final vertical dimension can also be determined by establishing dimension of rest and the vertical dimension with calipers and making the necessary adjustments. Any adjustments are later transferred to the stylus of the nathometer CAD. A turn to the right will raise the stylus, while a turn to the left will lower it. check the lip support and the buckle corridor. Make the necessary adjustments by cutting back or building up wax or silicone. Now mark the midline, the smile line, and the cuspid line as information for the dental technicians. They will lightly cut these lines with a fine round burr before the scanning procedure. Remove the white bite rims in preparation for the registration step. Use some wax to hold the adjusted screw in place. Attach the registration plate with the stylus to the upper jaw 3D bite plate by pressing it on the pre-cut retentive elements until it locks into place. Color the mandibular registration plate with a wax pen or permanent marker. Press the plate onto the 3D bite plate until it clicks into place. Inform the patient about the possible risk of injury before you insert the two impressions together with a mounted nathometer CAD. The tongue of the patient must not enter the space between the plates while the patient does the biting exercises. The patient carries out protrusive and laterotrusive movements to the left and to the right. You can guide the patient by indicating the direction of the lower jaw movements with your finger. The movements should be repeated 3 times in each case. When the direction is changed, the patient opens his mouth, swallows, and then closes the mouth again. When a clear arrowhead or Gothic arch is visible, remove the 3D bite plate from the upper jaw to record this position. If this is not the case, the tracing procedure has to be repeated. Mark the tip of the arrow with a permanent marker and record the position with a perforated plexiglass blank. In order to verify this position, the patient should be asked to find the centric position by themselves several times in a row. Subsequently, this situation is recorded with virtual CAD bite. Now you can mark the lip length. The facial meter is used to determine the width of the nose. This information provides a reference for the size of the teeth. Together with the patient, you can now select the desired tooth shape and shade. It is also important to find out from the patient if they would like the anterior teeth to have a straight, natural, or individualized position. Subsequently, send all the information you have collected to the dental laboratory.